Hey students, how are you all? Hope you all are doing good. So students, from the last two videos, we have started discussing about our geography lesson number 2. And students, what is it? It is globe, latitudes and longitudes. So we have started this. And in the first video, we have started discussing about globe, types of globe and the different point present on the globe and other imaginary lines. So students, always we need to remember whatever the reference points might be, the equator, axis, poles, all these things are just imaginary. And the other imaginary lines that we were talking about are our latitudes and longitudes. One will be running horizontally and the other vertically on the globe. Yes, students. So, and how are these latitudes and longitudes useful to us? They are useful in locating place on the globe and also to tell the time of a place. And when we have started discussing about the location, we have discussed about relative location, how we relate it to other landmarks or a direction. And in absolute location, how we tell a location of a place using the coordinates. For example, we have started seeing the coordinates of India. That is nothing but 37 degrees 6 minutes north to 8 degrees 4 minutes north. Then 68 degrees 7 minutes east to 97 degrees 25 minutes east. So as we have already seen in the last video, we did latitude first and longitude next. So, first was the latitudinal coordinates and next was longitudinal coordinate. So, students, in the last video, we have discussed latitudes, what are the characteristics of the latitudes, what are the important latitudes and importance of the important latitudes. That is nothing but differentiating the globe into temperature zones, which we also called as heat zones. Okay, so in that we have learned about 3 temperature zones or 3 heat zones. First, hottest is torrid, moderate climate, temperate, and the coolest is frigid. Yes. So, we have learnt all these things. So, students, I have a picture for you. Okay. Now, look at the India map and try to identify the important latitude that is passing through India. Can you all identify it? It is the Tropic of Cancer. And it is present at what degree, students? 23.5 degrees and the coordinate will be N. Yes, because it is present in the northern hemisphere. So, students, as you can see that the Tropic of Cancer does not pass through one state. It is passing through multiple states. So, the next thing what I want you to do is make a list of the states through which the Tropic of Cancer passes. Okay. You are going to do it? Very good. So students, as we have seen that any latitude may pass through one place or through multiple places. For example, we have a latitude that is 20 degrees south that passes through Tonga Islands in Pacific Ocean as well as the Mauritius Island in the Indian Ocean. So both places, both coordinates are same. The degrees are same, 20 degrees south. Now, how can we locate? But as we can see, Pacific Ocean is in one side and Indian Ocean is in other side, right? How can we tell the exact location of a place? To tell the exact location of a place, along with this horizontal lines, we will be needing the vertical lines that runs from north to south on the globe. So students, again a very big puzzle. What are these lines that is running from north to south on the globe? What is it called as? They are nothing but longitudes. Yes, exactly. To locate any place, we need both coordinates of latitudes and longitude. Then only we can tell the specific location of a place. So, we have seen about latitudes in the last video and in this video, we are going to learn about the longitudes and how to locate a place. So, are you all ready? Okay then, let's start. Latitudes, we have, so now longitudes are the vertical lines that are running from north to south. Okay, and we have seen that latitudes are circles, but longitudes are semicircles. Yes, and as we are comparing both latitudes and longitudes, then here we should say that latitudes never meet each other, whereas longitudes will be meeting at the poles. Okay, and the distance between longitude will be decreasing. The distance between the two longitudes will be highest at the equator, and as they will be moving towards the poles, it will be decreasing. Okay, students, just like latitudes, longitudes are also measured in degrees, and 1 degree is further divided into 60 minutes, and every minute is divided again into 60 seconds. Yes, so students, are all the latitudes of equal length? Are they of equal length, students? No, they are not of equal length, but whereas longitudes are of same length. Okay, but till now we were talking that distance between the longitude is difference, but the length of the longitude from north to the south is same. Okay, students, how many latitudes do we have? We have 181 latitudes. How they have 181? We have seen in the last video, right? Yes. So, what about longitude, students? How many longitudes do we have? Do you know? Okay. So, students, first tell me, a circle will be having how many degrees? A circle will be having 360 degrees. In the same way, a globe is also divided into 360 degrees. That means we are having 360 longitudes. So, as we have seen, the numbering of the latitudes, the equator was at 0. Why was the equator at 0? Because it was the lengthiest latitude. But here, as we are telling, all the longitudes are of same length. Then how did they decide which longitude to be present, to be kept at 0, or to be elected as 0 degrees? Okay, we will see how they have elected it. First of all, let's see what is that longitude. 0 degree longitude is the prime meridian, and this longitude will be passing through a place called Greenwich, which is present in England, where British Royal Observatory is present. So, students, how did they decide that this 0 degree longitude should be the one which is passing through the British Royal Observatory? Okay, now I want our Indian longitude to be as a prime longitude. Will the people allow? Then, how did the other countries accept the prime meridian which is passing through England? Do you want to know? Okay. So, actually, students, there was an International Meridian Conference held. It was in Washington, D.C. in United States, which was held in October 1884. It was held on the request of U.S. President Chester A. Arthur. Okay. So, main motive of this conference was to elect the prime meridian for the international use, that all the nations can use this prime meridian commonly. Okay. And then the decision was given to vote. In this meeting, 21 nations have participated, and they have decided with the majority of the vote that the prime meridian should be the one which is passing through the Greenwich. Okay, and the other things that were decided in this meeting were, from the point of prime meridian, the other longitudes will be divided into eastern part and the western part. So, other two sides will be east and west longitude, eastern and western longitudes, with 180 longitudes on east and 180 longitudes on west. And towards the east, the time will be added and towards the west time will be subtracted. So these were the few things that were decided in the International Meridian Conference. Okay, students, now a few important characteristics of the longitudes. As we have already said, we have 360 longitudes and prime meridian is the zero, and from prime meridian to all the longitudes towards the east are eastern longitudes, and they are numbered from 1 degree to 179 degrees. Okay, and towards the east they are eastern longitudes from 1 degree east to 179 degree east. Okay, so students, we have got only 179 plus 179 will be 358. So if we are adding 179 plus 179, we are getting 358 longitudes. Then what about the other two? Zero longitude, that is nothing but prime meridian is 1. And the exact opposite longitude of prime meridian is antipodal meridian, that is nothing but 180 degree longitude. So students, this 0 and 180 will not belong to any of the coordinates, neither it will be on the west side or on the east side. They are common for both. So as we have already got 358 prime meridian and 180 degree longitude, are two more. 358 plus 2 is 360. So we are having 360 longitudes. So students, as we were telling, that the distance between the two longitudes will be highest at the equator. So what can be the distance between them? Can you guess? You already know the number. Could not guess? It is 69 miles or 111 kilometers. And as we said, that the distance between the longitudes will be decreasing as they move towards the poles. That means they become zero. The distance will be becoming zero at the poles. Yes, students. And the other important characteristics is that meridians form great circles. So what is a great circle? Great circle is nothing but the line that divides the earth into two equal halves. Yes, so we have already seen a latitude that can divide the earth into two equal halves. What is it, students? Equator. Yes, equator, which is at 0 degree, will be dividing the earth into two equal halves. Now, for example, we can say two longitudes, when they join, they become a great circle. For example, 0 degrees and 180 degree, they together form a great circle. So we can say the meridians will be forming great circle. Now, what is the use of the great circle? The great circle are used to mark the shortest distance between the two places. Okay, it is said that when the great circles are used, people can locate or they can measure the shortest distance between any two places, which they normally cannot if they are not following the great circles. Basically, for locating the shortest distance, great circles are used.
The Earth is divided up into horizontal lines of latitude and vertical lines of longitude. Latitude is read first, longitude second. Lines of latitude, also known as parallels, are read in terms of north and south of the equator. The starting point is the equator, which is 0 degrees latitude. 90 degrees latitude north of the equator is the North Pole. 90 degrees south of the equator is the South Pole. Note that the poles are at a 90 degree angle from the equator. North of the equator is the northern hemisphere. South of the equator is the southern hemisphere. North of the equator we have the Tropic of Cancer. South of the equator we have the Tropic of Capricorn. Between these lines are the tropics. At 66 degrees, 33 minutes, 44 seconds north and south of the equator are the Arctic and Antarctic circles. Between here and the tropics is the temperate zone. Lines of longitude are also known as meridians. The starting point for reading longitude is the prime meridian, which is a line passing near the Royal Observatory in Greenwich near London in the United Kingdom. This site was chosen as the international zero longitude reference line by an international conference in 1884. The antipodal meridian of Greenwich is both 180 degrees west and 180 degrees east. West of the prime meridian is the western hemisphere. East of the prime meridian is the eastern hemisphere. To locate a precise point on the Earth's surface, degrees of latitude and longitude have been divided into minutes and seconds. There are 60 minutes in each degree, and each minute is divided into 60 seconds. For example, the coordinates for the Great Pyramid of Giza is written as 29 degrees, 58 minutes, 45.03 seconds north, 31 degrees, 8 minutes, and 03.69 seconds east. Now to show you how to read the coordinates of a precise point. The first example I will use is Mount Narrahoe in the North Island of New Zealand. As mentioned earlier, between each degree of latitude or longitude there is a division of 60 seconds. Right on the line it is 00 minutes, then it goes to 01, 02, 03 and so on. At the halfway point it would be 30 minutes followed by 31 minutes and so on until we get to 59 minutes before clicking to the next degree of latitude or longitude where the minutes would return back to 00. Now that I've shown you how to read latitude and...
So, students, in the video clipping you have seen how the latitudes and longitudes are located, how to read the coordinates of the longitudes and latitudes of related to any place. Okay, now let's try by ourselves. Let's see, can we now do it? Students, as you can see here, this is the earth grid, also called as geographical grid. Now, when is this grid formed? So, as we can see here, we are having few horizontal lines and few vertical lines. When they intersect, they will be intersecting at right angle. So, as we can see here, all they are meeting at the right angle, no? Yes. So, when these crisscrossing lines, when these lines intersect each other, they will be forming grids like this, as you can see on this screen. So, I am repeating, this is called as earth grid or geographical grid. So, now we will try to locate the coordinates of the places, what we have marked here. For we have to search for A, B, C, D. Okay. Now, here I have written A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Those are in capitals. So, here we are considering these as latitudes. Instead of 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, we have taken A, B, C, D. Okay. And these are in the northern hemisphere. That is why here N is written. Okay. On the other hand, we are having longitudes, which are numbered as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And these are in the eastern hemisphere. That is why E is mentioned here. So, students, first we will be finding the location of A. So, as we have seen that whenever we try to locate a place, the latitudes are read first, then longitudes. If we have to see, then the latitudinal position of A is B degree north. Yes, and then we will be seeing the longitude. So, it is at 2 degrees east. One more example, you would like to see? Yes, then we will be seeing for the B. What will be the latitude here? B, again, the coordinate N. What about the longitude then? It is placed at? What is here? 4 degree east. So one more example we'll see for C also. Okay, C is at E degree north and 5 degree east. So students, about D you have to find out. Okay, I hope it is clear for you. Till now we have tried to locate the places using ABCD 1, 2, 3, 4. Now let's try to do it with the same grid with the help of the other markings like 10 degrees, 20 degrees, we will be doing with that. Okay, students, as we have seen earlier, this is the same grid but I have changed the markings. So here you can see 0 degrees. It is a latitude that is equator. To the north we are having 10 degrees north, 20 degrees, 30 degrees, 40 degrees north. And towards the south, 10 degrees south, 20 degrees south, and there will be till 90 on the globe. So, and here this is our prime meridian. Towards the east, eastern longitudes, and towards the west, western longitudes. Okay, now we will be trying to locate the places. Okay, first we will be seeing for A. What will be the latitude? It will be 30 degree north. We have to see in this way, where is the latitude? And longitude is 10 degree west. Okay, students? Now for B, what will be the latitude? It will be 30 degree north. And longitude will be 10 degree. What will be the coordinate here, students? East. Yes. Now, talking about C. Where is it located? On the latitude 0 degree. Okay. So, what is the coordinate that we are going to write here, students? We are not going to write any coordinate because equator is at the center. It does not have any coordinates. Okay. So, next, longitude is here 20 degrees east. Okay, students. So, again, I am keeping a question mark here. I want you all to write the coordinate of D. Okay? Try it. So, yes, students. We have discussed in this video today about longitudes and how to locate a place. I hope you all have understood. So, next, as we were telling that longitudes and latitudes help us in locating a place which we have learned finally. Now comes to the next usage of these imaginary lines. That is nothing but to find out about a time of a particular place. Yes, that we will be seeing in the next video. And trust me, students, it is a very, very, very interesting topic. And yeah, a little bit complicated also. So, I want you all to be very serious when you are watching the videos. Till then, students, we'll be meeting in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.